First of all, it's my honor and privilege, and indeed a thing of joy for me on this occasion again, to welcome you all to this great state of Bayelsa on this annual conference. As you are all aware, this is the Jerusalem of the Jubilee. This is the new Bayelsa, where we are showing what is possible when you build partnerships, when you work with the right people, including NS, including the Ministry of Petroleum Resources, and all members of their teams, and all our development partners. So I welcome you, athletes, to Bayelsa, where the story of oil and gas actually started. And I hope that in the course of your deliberations, in the course of your time here in this great state, you'll be able to avail yourself the opportunity that you now have on this glorious land to see most of our historical and landmark sites, particularly the first oil well at Oloib, which is a few kilometers from here. Now, we are happy working with the Nigerian Content Development Board and all our partners on holding this annual interaction. This is very good, but this is actually what the new Bayelsa is about. We have the philosophy of bringing the world, and I mean the whole world, to Bayelsa, and also taking Bayelsa to the world. So I want to appreciate all our partners, I want to appreciate all sponsors, I want to appreciate all those who work tirelessly in various committees and at various levels to make this conference possible. For those of you who have been to Bayelsa before, you can see the tremendous changes that are going on. But part of what we are doing, and which is why you have most of these results, is because we place a lot of emphasis on building partnerships, on networking. And there are so many areas we can network and bring development to our people about. We have so many initiatives that we have pursued and currently pursuing, which are areas that those who are interested can work with us. Partnerships to advance the cause of human capacity development. Partnerships in providing jobs and skills for our young people. Partnerships in terms of sending people to school on scholarships and so on and so forth. Partnerships in turning agriculture as a veritable tool for wealth creation and job creation for our people and wealth generation. So I invite you all today, as you are here, and in the course of this deliberation, to also find time to discuss with most of our officials who are also here, who will be with you throughout this conference, to explore further what we can do together working for our people. And I'd like to thank particularly my good friend Ernest, and our petroleum minister who is ably represented here, and also the federal government ably led by our own President Jonathan, who has done so wonderfully well in all sectors. And what the federal government has done in the area of bringing about Nigerian jobs, creating Nigerian skills through the instrumentality of the local content policy is second to none, and they deserve a round of applause now. Here in Bayelsa, we are living witnesses to what this partnership has brought about. We are living witnesses to what this policy of Nigerian content has resulted in. We are aware of what is going on at Polaco, the massive factory that is coming up, and I can't wait, Ernest, for us to complete it and then get it commissioned so that we can get young men and women back to work again. And I'd like to also appreciate the federal government and the local, the man on the board and the officials of the local content development board for what they are doing, because I know that they have massive plans to build a befitting secretariat These are all things that will add to the development of both the physical infrastructure and outlay of our states, as well as opening up new vistas of possibilities and opportunities for employment and for our economy to be positively affected. Again, I want to appreciate what they are doing, and honestly, I can't wait for the day these projects and initiatives will be completed for us to all join hands in commissioning and putting them to use. But all in all, we are living witnesses in this state, this being the genesis of oil and gas exploration and exploitation in Nigeria. Most of you know that this is where oil and gas and this story in Nigeria started. And therefore, we have more than a fair knowledge of what comes with it. The challenges that come with oil production, its effect on the environment, and discussions on the social and economic well-being of our people. These are things that we know very well. And that's why when we see a government that understands the need to plow back, when we see the need to work with those kind of people, we grab it wholeheartedly. And that's why every year we have made a decision as a government to continue to work with the local content board and all these wonderful partners, and all of you, to make this conference a reality. And it will be our honor, it will be our pleasure every year to work together so that we can have this annual interaction where we can deepen our understanding of the industry and how we can make the industry serve the needs of our people. In this state, we know that far more than most states, because we have produced oil and gas for a much longer period than most states, we know that oil and gas is a wasting asset. And the resources, oil and gas, the resources that comes with that, should not be treated as an end in themselves, or rather as a means to an end, because they can dry up. Oil wells will dry up one day. And so when we have this kind of opportunity where through local content policy, we are not just thinking of how to exploit resources, but we are thinking of how to use those resources as a means for job creation, as a means for skills development, as a means for affecting our economy positively, we are very, very happy. And I want to use this opportunity again to thank the federal government for making Bayelsa the home of Nigerian content development. So this is the home not just of food, oil, this is not just the Jerusalem of oil and gas exploitation, this is also now the home of Nigerian content development. And I can't thank the federal government enough for this. I'd like to appreciate what my good friend Ernest and all his officials are doing, and let me also acknowledge the wonderful support that I know that he and members of his team have always had from the supervising ministry. Now, going forward, our expectations as a people, and this is something that will form a part of my remarks next year, God willing. By next year, I will be interested on the statistics of how many local content jobs that have been created for Bayelsans. I say this because while it is good to talk about Nigerian content, as governor of Bayelsa, and knowing what our people have gone through, and Bayelsa now being acknowledged as the headquarters of local content development, my good friend and honorable minister will also be interested in Bayelsa content. So, you are actually talking about two contents. You have a larger Nigerian content development policy, and then for us here, we're also interested in the Bayelsa content. My officials have been directed already to liaise with Ernest and members of his team. And Ernest, by the way, is a wonderful gentleman. He's working closely, collaborating effectively with us. So I know that by next year, when we assemble here, we should be able to tell Bayelsa the practical benefits of our newfound and rightly deserved position as the headquarters of content development in Nigeria. But we appreciate that we have you here. And let me also say that we look forward to housing or hosting or accommodating here in this glory of all lands, not just the local content development and monitoring board, but all other regulatory boards and parastatals in the oil and gas industry. But we have made a good start by having the local content board here. But we also look forward to having the DPR, we look forward to having NAPIMS, we look forward to having all those other ones which will complement the work of the local content development board. But all in all, ladies and gentlemen, I join all others, and particularly the Honorable Minister and my good friend Ernest, in welcoming you all. I expect that you will avail yourself of this opportunity to have a proper and full feel of Bayelsa. Here you are in a state that is adjudged locally and also internationally as one of the safest and most stable states. So feel free to go anywhere your heart pleases, anywhere your legs and your body are able to take you to, and enjoy Bayelsa to its fullest. When we have good men and women like you in our midst, we have a saying here in the new Bayelsa that all good human beings are first Bayelsans. So to us, all of you good people are from Bayelsa. So you are welcome home, enjoy yourselves, and feel free also to explore the various potentials and opportunities here. This is not just the home of oil and gas. This is not just the headquarters of Nigerian content. This is the headquarters of tourism and hospitality and entertainment. This is Nigeria's best kept investment secret. And you have all come, so you have an opportunity to unveil and discover that secret. Here, whatever you put on ground here, whatever investments you make here are safe. And of course, you have the local content board that is just here. Ernest, I received an intelligence, but for now, you talked about facilities that are ever improving, and you are very right. But I received an intelligence that for now, most of the meetings that ought to be taking place here in Yenagoa are still taking place in Lagos, in Abuja, and in some other places. Contrary to the letters and the spirit of our designation as the headquarters of local content board. You know, you can see my talk is not academic, because this is practical Nigerian content talk. So I'd like to enjoin us all, particularly now that you have a safe environment, now that you have a government that is aware to its social responsibilities, now that you can see that our facilities, hospitality facilities, transportation facilities are fast coming up. By this time next year, hopefully, when we shall be assembling here by the grace of God, our airport would have been ready, Ernest. So, for all our guests who are thinking of, oh, how do we get to Bayelsa? Now it's safe, so there's no issue about safety. And I'm happy that I'm seeing all of you here. Safer than anywhere, safer than most places that you are currently domiciled. Our airport will be set, our helipad And there is no state that has the kind of heliport we are building. Our leisure and sports and entertainment facilities are second to none. So really, this is where every investor should be. This is where all of you who are doing various businesses in oil and gas should be. But we have made a major leap, and we should all acknowledge it. The Nigerian government has made a major leap by the emphasis placed on the development of local content. And I know that with the kind of robust partnership that this state has with the Local Content Development and Monitoring Board and its officials and all the leaders in that industry, working together with the kind of determination and focus that we jointly share, I've no doubt that this state will reap the benefits of Bayelsa local content in no distant time. It's on this note, ladies and gentlemen, that I declare this conference open.
First of all, I would like to use this opportunity to congratulate the federal government, Mr. President in particular, and his team on this concept of promoting and deepening local participation. That's one. Then second, I would also like to appreciate the good work of the Executive Secretary of the Local Content and Monitoring and Development Board, Mr. MS Wafa, is doing with his team. This is the first conference. And this is about the third time we are hosting it. We have made a commitment in Bayelsa. Knowing the importance of promoting local content, we have made a commitment working with the board to always host this conference every year. And I want to thank that this is going to be a rather exciting conference. Already we have inspected most of the companies and the stands, and I think there is no doubt whatsoever that the local content development policy has really impacted positively on our economy, and it has really achieved its objective of encouraging indigenous enterprise in that sector. We can clearly see the evidence, and moving forward we hope that it will only get better. And I made a point while talking of Nigerian content, next year I will also want to see some stands showcasing Bayelsa content. So all in all, great conference, and I want to congratulate the organizers. And I look forward to a better one next year. Thank you very much.